had to go in, you know, before she had to get up and go in before 8:30. So she's already gone. All right, good morning, everyone. I am going live here. Give me like 2 minutes, Mr. Paul, and I will be on, okay? I will let you know when we are fully 100% live, and I'll make the comment that I am live. All right, hang tight. I got my share logo up. I got my connection in. Good morning, everybody. This is PAA. This is Joe with our live show. Welcome back to another live show. In a moment, I'm going to have Paul Lovelace online here. And right now, I'm posting out to the comments that I am live so people can see it. All right, now I'm going to minimize. All right, guys, so we're here waiting for some people to pop in. We're working on the AMT D8H Caterpillar Bulldozer today again. We're doing the opposite side of the tracks today, the drive tracks. I have already set everything up. I've already done the numbering. And as you see, I got papers around my little build area here. That's so I don't do the oopses from yesterday. Speaking of oopses from yesterday, Keith, you're right.
Just wait until he comes online, Joe.
Okay. All right. I'll wait then. All right.
See if he shows up. That way I can explain myself.
All right. I can hear you too, so I know that you're getting through, Paul.
Right.
All right. Cool. So I'm just waiting now. I put the
just
live
let
out.
Let me know when he shows up.
Yeah. It usually takes 2 to 3 minutes before people start the show. They see it. It pops up on their notifications.
That's fine,
they go.
But if
yeah.
If he comes on, let yeah. me know, and I'll explain myself from yesterday.
Yeah. I got you. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and do the future comings. Future comings are the new one is going to be the AMT. Pumper truck, you guys. I saw. I showed you guys yesterday. So you guys gotta watch out for an open bus. You guys gotta watch it. And Paul found one. What was it, in Tennessee or Georgia, Paul?
Georgia.
So Paul found one in Georgia. So we may be doing a long distance buddy build on that one, guys. But that's the next build that I'm. Well, not the next build, but that's an upcoming build. I have so many builds going right now. I'm probably going to be starting out. My wife wants to see what the 40s coupe looks like, so my next build after the dozer will probably working on the flatbed and getting it color combined with the Mac and the dozer, and then I'll be going into the 40s instantly because it's that show's coming up in the next 5 months. So I want to get that done and have it set and ready and get be able to do any details. You know, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks ahead of time.
So I think the trailer. It's already got the wood grain and everything.
Yeah. No, I'm not changing. I'm not changing any of that. I'm gonna add a little bit of tan because the Mack truck has a little bit of tan on it. Has military tan on it. So I'm just gonna add some accents and stuff like that, and maybe a little silver to it or something like that, just to kind of match it up with the bulldozer and the Mack. That's gonna be the full set now that I got that. So that'll just stay together like that. Of course, unless I get a backhoe or something, then I'll worry about that from that point.
Okay.
But so far, you guys, just so you guys know, that's upcoming, which is the AMT pumper truck, along with all the other things that we did. I want to give a shout out to Lad's Body Repair and Detailing. They're in Mount Sterling, Ohio. Their number is on the screen.
Go
talk to Dave. Dave is an awesome dude. He's very friendly. He will take care of any and all of your problems. And he might give you 15% off for mentioning my name or Place the Credentials Anonymous. He mentioned that I think
how much?
15% off and anybody that mentions my name or Plastic Addictions Anonymous. That's a pretty good deal if you ask me. So okay, we have Miss Candy. Good morning, Miss Candy. We have Tony Hello. Leonard. Hello, Tony, man. God, my goodness, I wasn't expecting you, sir. Glad to have you. We were just discussing
what
up.
The hell?
I have Paul Lovelace on live on the line, just so everybody knows. Paul, Candy is in, and so is Tony.
Hey guys.
He is actually in Ohio on his job. He's traveling from one point to another.
Driving, so
yeah, so he chimed in. Good morning, Mr. Keith. How are you, Jeff? All right. Good. I'm glad you came in this morning, Jeff. I've already done basic the intro and stuff like that. I've done my shout out, stuff like that. I have Paul on the line, Jeff, and he would like to explain something to you. Let me know if you can hear him. Go, Paul.
Good morning, Jeff. Can you hear me okay?
Candy says hi, Paul, as well. Jeff says good.
What?
Jeff says good.
Hi, Candy. Okay, Jeff. Yesterday on the live show, I made a comment, oops, after you had posted something, and then my phone froze. I saw no other comments till after the show. During that show, Joe was talking about other guys who do videos building. They don't show mistakes. They show it as a perfect build. Joe said he likes to do it with mistakes.
The oopses.
It's more realistic.
The oopses, right.
As soon as he got done, he made an oops. He had the wrong part. So I typed oops. So there was nothing you had done about putting model truck in decal.com. So there was nothing you did the oops was meant for Joe. I just want to clarify that. But nothing, you know, you did nothing wrong, buddy.
Jeff, did you get all that, pal? In a nutshell, Paul was watching the video shortly after you posted model trucking, and I asked someone to find me. I asked you guys to find me something that I could get Caterpillar decals from. You posted in the model trucking world decals.com or whichever was. I'll go back and look at it again. And then Paul said, oops, that was not meant for your post. That was more meant for, because of, I had just discussed that I'd like to record my oopses, and I had made an oops because I had the wrong part in my dang hand. But that's not going to happen today, guys, because as you see, I am already, each one of these little pieces of paper that you see in front of you have exactly the parts that are supposed to go on. I already did a couple of things. I did 101 and 102. I put them together, and I left one to show you what it was. You know, it's just the same thing as the last year. But we wanted to clarify with Jeff that Jeff did nothing wrong by either putting the post in of a link or any verbal, nothing. Jeff, you did nothing wrong, pal, okay? It was all good.
Not in a live show.
Yeah, no, it was a live show, man. If I ask you something on a live show and somebody goes and gets it for me and finds it and posts it, it's not a problem, guys. You know, it's the same thing as asking for a link and then us saying yes. Same principle. You ask for something, we go find it for you. So you just tried to help me out in finding decals, and I do appreciate that.
Yeah,
all right.
Just bad timing.
Jeff says, yes, he got all that, and cool. Did you catch that, Paul?
No, I didn't.
Okay, Jeff said, yes, he got all that, and cool.
Cool.
So he understands. All right.
Thumbs up.
All right. Cool. All right. So we're all good now. Like I said, I tried to clarify that with you, Jeff, yesterday as well on the live. As soon as I realized what I thought you were talking about was the link. What Paul thought you were talking about was his oops to your link. No, it was more of the oopses that I had just made after discussing that I like to film the oopses. You know, because these guys that build a perfect build and it comes out all perfect at the end, you know, we want to see what they went through to get it that way, not just getting it that way. You know, what'd you go through? What'd you have them fix? What'd you have to change in the kit because the kit came a little messed up or it wasn't quite right, or you put the wrong part in the wrong place because the instructions didn't look right, something of that nature. All right, so we got that clarified. We're going to move on with the build. Paul, love you, brother. Hang around for a while if you can. I know you're still working and stuff. I appreciate you yelling, and I appreciate you calling in. We want our members to know that, you know, if they feel something that they did something wrong, or if they feel that they said or acted some way, we want them to clarify that with us, if the feelings, to make sure that, you know, if that's happened, that's happened. If it's not, it's not. But we don't want you guys walking around feeling that, you know, you did something wrong and you're going to get chastised for it. Oh, not like chastised, you know what I mean. You're going to get a problem out of it. It's no problem, guys, okay? My lives are pretty much open. So if I say I'm looking for something and you guys post a link, it's an open live, guys. It's perfectly fine. I asked the question. It's just like if, let's say, Lad's Auto Body Repair wanted to pop out a, you know, link to their email. I said, go for it. No problem. Works for me. I mean, it's a little different when we're, you know, posting stuff in PAA. I think it's just because I can control here quicker than I can from the PAA, because I can knock it down if I need to. Like if we get an idiot in here and he wants to post something he shouldn't, I can knock it down to the comments before really it ever gets through the live after I'm done. It'll be gone as soon as I'm done with the live. So that's what I'm saying. Sometimes I don't catch what people post, but while I'm sitting here, I can catch everything. I have removed a few.
Well, and then let me say something, Joe.
Go ahead.
If there is a mistake made or a rule broken, we don't air it out. You will get a friendly private message from Joe or I explaining what happened and make everything cool that way. So if there is a mistake made or a rule broken, you're not chastised on the page. You will get a private message and just explaining why we did what we did.
Right. Exactly, Paul. Exactly.
You know, we don't rip on anybody for anything.
No. I mean, really, Paul's right. You really got to screw up in our groups. I mean, really, several times, guys. I mean, it's going to have to be a repetit. Say it, Paul.
The worst thing you can do is scream at us when we're trying to explain something.
Correct. There you go. The repetitive of things that we ask you not to do, we go in and we're nice about it 5, 6, 7 times. Now we may end up, you know, just saying, you know, between us, it's not going to get out to the group. We're going to deal with it behind the scenes. You know, which we've done. I mean, I've got some, you know, and we run another group called the Model Asylum. And in the Model Asylum, I do weirder things than I do here on PAA, guys. people take it wrong sometimes as to, you know, me harping on addiction. It's not that. It's a comedy thing for me. It's kind of making the lightheartedness of our plastic addiction. We in no way are, you know, condoning addiction or saying that addiction is a bad, or not a bad thing, saying that addiction is a thing that shouldn't be discussed, because it should be, or played upon. I'm surely not playing out upon anybody's major addictions. I'm not. If you get offended, PM me. Let me know and I'll remove you from that post. That's not a problem. Jeff says, I just didn't want to break any of the rules and get anybody in trouble. Thanks for explaining. So he's got it.
You're all good, Bubby.
Yeah, everything's good, brother. It's all good. I just went ahead while we were talking.
That was all on me. That was...
No, actually, that was on me because I did the oops and you were just responding to me and Jeff thought you were responding. Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't even think of him posting the decal link.
Neither did
I.
Yeah.
I was ripping on the other admin.
Yeah, he was busting my chops because I had just said I wanted to do normal, like live. You guys get to see the oopses and how I have to fix and stuff to make it look right. And that's all he was commenting on, Jeff. So you're all good, brother. I appreciate you coming in. I love everybody. Tony, I didn't forget you, brother. I appreciate you coming in. Holy cow, man, it's your first trip. I hope you enjoy the show. I'm a little more organized today, guys. I have all my parts in, and I got smart today, and I kind of numbered everything on paper as well as, as well as put a couple of things together. Over here we have the 113, 114, which is the drive wheel parts here. These were two parts. I put them together. That was 13 and 14. Jeff Keith says, love you guys. I appreciate it there, Jeff. We love you too, brother. I appreciate you coming in and hanging out with us for sure. I hear Paul turning his blinker on, so he might not be far from where he's going. But I went ahead and put 113 and 114 together. I put most of the 102 and 101s together, which is just these pulleys. All right. I did label everything. You guys probably can't see that, can you? You can't see it. But I put a pin number. I put a number in here, which coincides to what the instructions are. So we should go pretty smooth today, guys. Like I said, I put everything on paper. These are all the 101 and 102s put together. There should be, and I didn't count that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 199 are there as well. So I got one of these in here that's a little different, so I got to find that. So I don't think I have one that's different, though. They all look the same. So, oh, nope, that one's a little thinner in this inside. Okay, so we're gonna do exactly what we did yesterday. We're gonna just follow the instructions. I have them up on my board. Again, we're working on the bulldozers. We're gonna go until this thing is done and I'm ready to do any decals and stuff, because then I'll just go try to find them and see where I can find for them. Other than that, shout out to YouTube for like, subscribe, share, follow, and hit that bell so you get notifications of things like this. I went ahead also and pulled this little part, and I went ahead and painted the chrome because I noticed on the box these were silver. As you see, I've still got more to do. It was like a rough one this morning real quick because I noticed these were silver. The outer of the full rim up the front is silver, as well as the entire cog for the back for the drive was silver on the box. So I went ahead and did that. I also wanted to comment that I am making these stiff and glued into place, not letting them roll, as because I'm going to be putting it on a trailer, and when I move the trailer, I don't want it to roll back and forth. So, all right. So now here we go. We're going to take one. We're going to take 71 and 70, and we're going to marry them together, just like that, just like I did yesterday. First things first, we got to get the bigger stuff done and ready to roll. So I'm just going to take a little bit of glue, and as I said, I put numbers on it on everything, so I know I'm handling the right parts today. Yesterday I was kind of
foggy.
Maybe. I don't know. You know me, man. My handshake. I'm going to get an oops or two at least in every video, brother. You know me. Oop, I think I got... Okay, I got Walgreens calling me again. You know they've been calling me since Saturday? Last Saturday?
Yeah.
Every day last week, if you recall, they called me and told me that I had meds ready. And I went to my doctor before you came here, Paul. I went to my doctor. And they've been doing every day. I've gotten a message from them. But yet, I'm not out of my meds because they're not due. You know what I mean? So I went to my doctor early because he went on vacation early. So I went to my doctor 10 days early. So they automatically send them in through the electronic thing. So as soon as Walgreens hits them, they try to fill them. So when they can't fill them, what do? They call my insurance company. They call my doctor. And all they have to do is look at the date that I picked up. And they'll know that, oh, well, he's not out yet. You know, so I'm just trying to ignore them, but they're getting very annoying with it every day. Okay, this is 71. These are 71s, both of these. And number 70 is going to be the little tiny pin. Okay, that goes inside like we did the other day. And that little pin pretty much goes. Let's see if I can do this right now, guys. I got to watch the instructions now. So we got to put it in here. It goes up front. So it goes in here. And this Also, just so you guys know, this they said I could make slide. Okay, a little bit back and forth. But I put it in place again because I don't want it to move around on the shelf because, you know, I have a cat. So I'd rather it be kind of secure. So we're going to put the number 67 to connect the number 70 and 71 to the side of the chassis. We're just going to put a little glue on the flat part there on the bottom and put it into place. And then we'll have that little piece done. And then we can work on the wheels as we go by. I do have the little one over here, 99 and 100 right there ready. Also, I wanted to show you guys all the problems I was having finding all these things yesterday. I found the 103s and put them together already, just so you guys. 103s and 112s. I have everything laid out. We're going to put this in next. This basically is just, excuse me, goes into here like so. And that's all it does. And then it glues into the side of the wheel chassis, like right in here. So when we get to that, I'll show you guys how to do that anyways. So we got that basically ready to rock and roll. We want to put the front wheel in. All we got to do is put the front wheel, the small spindle, inside the slot area. Now that we have glue on the tip of this, we can take this and just put it right on the pin, right down inside, and it should snap right inside like that. And it should supposed to move like this. It's supposed to move because that's an adjustment for the tracks. I'm assuming they loosen these bolts up and then they slide it back and forth to adjust the tracks or remove the tracks. That's basically what it is. I'm making a solid one, so I'm going to put a little extra glue, just a drop of extra glue on the back of the flat piece of that because I want it to be solid. And I'll adjust the tracks as I need to. It's no big deal. Also, I noticed I think I'm going to have a couple of extra pieces. I don't know what they're from or what they were supposed to go to, but this kit I didn't think had any extra, but it does look like I might. So we'll see that. All right, so now we're going to do the same thing with what we did yesterday. We're going to take each and every one of these. The 99 and 100, which is this one, is a little smaller. So if I have this laid out correctly, that would go to the very back end one here, like so. Okay, it's just a little bit smaller. It's not much smaller. And then we just add the rest of these as we go. And let's see, 101 and 102s go right on down the line. So we just put these in here. Again, they make these things slide and move. Okay, all this stuff. I'm making it permanent. I don't want my vehicle. Same thing I do with my trucks. I try my best not to make them move because I don't want my cat or accidents happen. You know, when you're moving another kit, you bang it. It just rolls right off the shelf on you. All right, so I'm just going to put a little dab of glue on each one of these holes. Just like one glue dab. Trying not to get any string on it. So everybody, I hope everybody had a good, very good night. And I'm trying to catch up on the comments. I see. Oh, thanks, Tony, man. I appreciate that, brother. And thanks, Candy, for sharing it, babe. I really do appreciate it. I've given you shout-outs, Tony. Don't worry, man. No, you're not worried. That's not the way I meant it. I give you guys shout-outs on my first whole month. Was you guys. I didn't really have anybody to shout out, so I shouted out you guys and a couple other model builders. But now I'm getting a few of my members that come in and say, hey, you know, I own a business, and, you know, you want to give me a shout out? I give them a shout out. No big deal, man. I don't expect nothing. It's fun. I appreciate you guys coming in. If you're giving you guys a shout out, makes you come in, or word of mouth makes you come in, man, I did my job. I try to be fun. I try to be, you know, like I said, I don't. This is for Tony. I know I've said this before, but I don't hide the oopses. I don't edit my videos. And I'm sure anybody that's been any of my live on our phones when Paul was here knows that some of our videos really suck. I mean, really. And that's all Facebook, guys, because every time I record and push it to YouTube, I don't have that problem, not a bit. So, are you watching online there, Paul, or are you still driving, brother? Oh, we may have lost him. You leave, brother? No, you're still here. Did you pull into your lot yet? All right, so the same thing is going to go here. The rear wheel gets put glued into place here with the little pin going down. All right, I'm still trying to figure out which one of these was supposed to be smaller. I really do believe that was the smallest one. I think I put it in the wrong place. See, there's an oops, guys. That's the 99 and 100, not that one. I had to look at the sizes while they were all together, so that should fit perfectly now. I know they look all the same to you guys, but they're not. So that should be good now. All right, so a little bit there. Okay, so now we're going to put this into place, and hopefully we got it right. Which way is the ball? Okay, once you put the rear end in, the oval pieces, there's a cutout in it, goes to the inside, guys, and the outside gets the flatter piece. So I did want to go ahead and paint it. Like I said, as you see, I painted them. I wasn't going to, and then I realized that the box actually had them painted silver. They're calling it Silver Fox or some silly thing like that or whatever, but I just went ahead and did with my silver. So I just want to make sure that goes in the hole correctly so it's sitting correct. That's good there. We're good there. We're going to make sure everything's fitting in. Why is that not fitting in now? See, there's another, oops, guys. It's not fitting in for some reason. All right, there we go. Let's try that. All right, let's try to get this. Okay, now I'm just going to put the glue on this other side, and we're going to run the other pins. So this is the 103s that I put together. So let's see. It says that the 103s go onto these, which is number 68 and 69, or 50, yes, 68 and 69 are these pins. So one of each goes on here like so, and then they go on the side of the body once I get the body all put together. So for right now, we're just going to kind of put the body together, drop a couple of spots of glue here on each one of these little holes, because like I said, I am not making it roll, and I will clean it up when I'm all done, and you won't see any of the glue and stuff anyways. I don't want to make it roll, like I said. I want to make it solid. So you guys can make the choice of making it solid or not. I mean, that's totally up to you guys. I have my own preferences, as everybody does. Like I said, I have my preferences to show you guys everything that I screw up. And if I screw up, you guys see how I fix it. This way, if you guys have that same problem on the kit that I built here live, you guys know how to go around it, or how I went around it. Anyways, you may not know how perfectly to go around it, but you know how I went around it. All right, so now we got that into place. Got that into place. That seems to be good now. Got to put the head up. Okay, so now we got the other side pretty much built on side. Okay, now I didn't put any glue on the top piece here because I'm figuring that these are going to be points that are going to be glued enough to hold it in place. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the edge of my board to kind of flatten them out. I want to make sure that they're all pushed up. You know, this way my tracks roll, they don't get stuck on them. So, all right, so all the tracks are pushed up. All the tracks are pushed up to the top area now. So we have number two side pretty much built, like I said. I'm going to go ahead and add some glue. Hang on, guys. Oops, there we go. I didn't add any glue in here. I need to just kind of separate it a little bit. Yep. Just going to kind of separate it a little bit here and just kind of add some to the backside because it's not wanting to close right. I was hoping it was just going to seal together, but it's not. Okay, so that should take care of that. I need to quit pressing it too because it keeps popping. All right, so we got that basically done. I'm not going to bother with it anymore for a second to hopefully get it to stay put. I need to put the other pin inside here on this side, and that is number 67. Goes to the opposite side on the front wheel as well, which again is this little tiny piece here, which I put a little bit of glue on the pin, and now I'm just going to put a little bit of glue. And I got dog hair on my glue. Can you believe that? Dog hair. Dog ain't even over here yet. Whoops. Oh my God, Paul, that's loud. Holy crap. That's enough to wake you up in the morning.
I guess I ought to put my seatbelt on.
Yeah, hey, by the way, Paul, put your seatbelt on, man. Jeez, that'll wake
you. I'm driving through a parking lot.
That'll wake you up in the morning, though, brother. Jeez. All right,
just
so
making sure you're still awake.
I'm still here, man. And if I wasn't, I am now. All right, so we did that. Now, the only parts that really I have to put on is, oops, see, did it again. Check it out, guys. See, that was exactly what I mean. No, can anybody guess what I missed from yesterday? Somebody tell me what I missed from yesterday. Oh, hey, Steven, man, I didn't see you pop in. Hey, buddy, how are you? I have Steven Mountain as well there, Paul. I missed breakfast, too. I missed number, what the heck was it? Number 112, guys. I was supposed to put it in here, remember? So, see, another oops. See, you guys get to see me pull it back apart. That's what I get for talking and not looking at instructions and just building from what I see here in front of me. okay, so we got that piece in now. We're going to let it sit up for a second. The other one has the same spot up front that the one yesterday did. So I'm just kind of putting everything together as I go along. I don't think I've looked at the instructions more than once, because now that I did the other side, once I got everything built, I knew where everything went. So we're just going to do that. Put it right up here in the same spot, right up behind it. Right there's where it goes. There's a slot inside the side track here that little angler goes. Okay, so now I just got to touch up the glue again. Just kind of, I'm not even putting really any glue on it. I'm just kind of touching the tip of it so that it kind of moistens the glue back up that's already there. I don't want to add glue. Just want to kind of make it a little bit more moist. Moist and delicious. All right, here we go. Back together. Now I think I got everything ready. If this goes back together, I will be. If this goes back together without giving me a problem, guys, somebody give me a kudos. Or a Dewey button. Whatever. But so far,
buy you a cookie.
That's good. Buy me a cookie. No, actually, no. I don't want anybody to buy cookies. My wife makes better cookies than anybody I know.
That's why I'm buying you a cookie. You don't get the good stuff.
I don't get the good stuff. Yeah, right. Nah, Paul.
She does make a wonder. She makes a. I'm gonna say it on here. I don't care.
Go ahead.
She makes a hell of a pecan bar.
Okay, it's you were right. It had pecans in it because she was out of regular stuff that she usually puts in it. It's
oh,
called,
that thing was good.
It's called a seven-layer bar, guys. There's seven different layers of goodness, and there's peanuts in it and chocolate in it, and she puts all, you know, it's really good.
More Paul, like a seven heaven.
Paul got treated a couple, Paul, thank you, Paul. Make sure she hears that. Paul
oh
got,
my God, that was delicious.
Paul was here for a week, so he got treated to my wife's goodies. That's something she does every year, every Christmas. I guess we'll have to put you on that Christmas list there, Paul.
That didn't sound right.
right? All right. So at this point, we have everything together, and I actually have the cross members in place. Finally, something went right on this for me. All right, so that looks like it's a little tight, though, to me, guys. Does it look like to you? Look tight to you? All right, so, okay, there we go. I got it. All right, so now we're going to bring the part up here. Going to make sure that that is right where it's supposed to be. All right, we're good there. Nice and straight. Don't want them bent up. And there we have it, guys. The basic other side of the track. I'm going to go ahead, because this one's fighting me for some reason. So I'm going to go ahead and see if I can find out why. They don't seem to be any difference in size, I don't think, anyway. It doesn't look like it. So I don't know if I put one in the wrong place, because they're all the same, you know, that what was left over, and I did yesterday, so I'm assuming that sooner or later that will be where it's supposed to be. Oh, that's what it is. That wasn't straight. Okay, so I got it. All right, you guys get to hear me go, blah, 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 blah. Oh, you're working on your... I love having somebody work with me, brother. Steven, I just realized what you said, brother. I'm glad to hear it. I love having people that work with me when I'm working on a model. Paul will tell you. That's why we basically turned our little competition into a basic buddy build. He built one way, I built another. We just wanted to show you guys, you know, how different we are in our thoughts. And, you know, when we see a kit, how many ways that you can actually do it. And we showed you guys that that's you know, that's pretty much what it was. We just decided to go ahead and do a buddy build. I'm going to leave the rollers roll, okay? I am not going to let these smaller rollers roll. The bigger ones, the drive rollers and stuff, I'm going to let it roll due to the fact of I want to be able to move them a little bit so I can get the chain on properly. All right, so now that that's all put together, got a little bit of a problem going on here, guys, just so everybody sees. I don't know if anybody can see that, but I'm having a problem getting the two pieces to line up properly and stay in place, even though I put glue on it. So I'm probably going to have to rubber band it after I do it, and it's probably going to have to set overnight because I got a little bit of a separation up front too, which I shouldn't have because everything went together so good. So we're going to go ahead, and I'm going to get my tip first, and then I'm going to go ahead and put a little glue in it. So, Mr. Tony, when's your next auction, brother? I'll yell at you for a minute. How about that, Tony? When's your next auction, brother? You're welcome to put dates and stuff up here, bro. Let everybody know about it. Anybody that sees the live feed will know about it. Tony and Candy run a live auction. For anybody that doesn't know, I guess if you don't know Tony and Candy's auctions by now after being on our group, you probably never will. But they run an auction group called It's All Junk. It's pretty freaking cool, guys. It's freaking cool. They have some fun. Candy gets the wop up on Tony once in a while, and Tony gets a word in edgewise now and then back on it. So you guys go check it out. Again, that's a Facebook group. It's called It's All Junk. Check it out. It's amazing, unless you changed it. Saturday, Tony says, guys, Saturday is his next auction. What time, Tony? It's your time, Tony. So I'm Eastern, so whatever yours are, let us know. It's Eastern Central. I'm 99% sure that I got something wrong here, guys. 99% sure something's wrong here. But it just does not want to line up like it's supposed to, and that doesn't make any sense. The other one lined up perfectly, right? Okay, the other lined up perfectly. Let me take a look at this. Oh, you know what I did? Hey, guys, oops, from yesterday. Check it out. I know exactly what I did. Oh, man. All right, you ready? Okay, yesterday, I was supposed to have number 198. What I did was I have two 198s in this rail alone. So I have to pop this one out and pop the back one out here. So that's all it is. I'm glad this one isn't dry yet. That one is, though. That's going to be a pain. But that's what I'm going to do. See, there's oops number two on this. See? And that's why I was saying it didn't look like there was a match. So I'm just going to, I only did glue on one side. Hopefully I can take my blade and pop it right loose. Let's see what happens. I only put a little bit. Let's see if I did enough. There's one. Cut around. There's two. I did it. Okay, cool. Okay, that's rolling now. Now let's see if I can pop them all loose. You know what? Maybe I will make a roll, guys. How about that? Let's see if I can pop them all loose and make them all roll. How about that? I only use a little bit of glue. And if you only use a little bit of glue, you should be able to get through it without hurting, doing any damage. So, but I do have to pop this front one out. And it's really loose, so it's good. So, Paul, you missed another oops, buddy.
Huh?
You missed another oops, buddy. I'm having to do surgery on yesterday's track.
No, I'm not gonna say nothing.
Don't say nothing. Don't do it. Don't do it. No fair. All right, so.
Get a whole week of oops.
You're right. I did. You're right. So. But
no,
it was.
I know.
But you know me. I don't glue a lot. I don't put a lot of glue on it. So if I do mess up, see, there you go. Popped right off. I didn't put much glue at all. So I can show you guys the difference now that I got this part. Okay. So we have both of them now, right? I got the other one apart now too. All right. So 199 looked like that, guys. Okay. It looks like that. Okay. That's 199. 101 and 102 look like that. So there is a big difference. And those two parts, I don't know if you guys can see it or not, but I'm trying to. Let me get this, you know, get this light out of your way. Maybe there you go. Is that better, guys? Gonna pull good gits for Saturday's auction so I can buy more. I buy my dog a kayak. Cool. You got to picture that, man. I got to see. 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for Tony Leonard's auctions, guys. Go check him out. Anyways, these are the two pieces. I'm just trying to follow along, guys, while I'm trying to do this and not stay off track. I get off track fast. Anybody will tell you I get off track easy. All right, so. Basically, why my second track was not rolling properly like I wanted to is I had the 99 and 100 in the wrong place on the other track. Now, this should line right up. This should roll. Should be away from it. And the track should actually line up. And guess what happened, guys? The track lined up. So, and it rolls now. See? All right. So, that was my problem. That's what I did. So, I now know what I got to do. I just got to put this back into its spot. And I'm going to try to get these all to roll because I decided that now that I got it open, I wasn't going to, but now that I got it open, I didn't use enough glue to hurt anything. So maybe I can get these to roll. That one feels a little tight. Let's see what happens here, guys. Get some of them to roll would be nice anyway. Just looking for the really loose ones that I didn't put a lot of glue on. All right, I know the 101 and 199 I can do. Okay, so I got them all rolling. Okay, so now we're going to go through and try to get these things to stay together. So we're going to put it down here. I'm going to set them down. Right next to where they're going to go. And in a minute, I'm going to put them all back together. So, now, back together on this thing. So that the back wheel rolls, I'm just going to put a little glue in the pin area. And now I'm going to try to put some glue all the way across the top here. I'm throwing it down here. You guys can't see me. I'm sorry, guys. Let me get my thing back up so I can see what I'm doing and showing you. Okay, here we go. Excuse me. I pulled yesterday's track apart. This is yesterday's track. So the way I'm going to do this now so that the rest of the wheels stay rolling is I'm just going to glue to the actual box, and I'm not going to glue to the pins. So hopefully this works out for me. And then I got this pin in here to help hold the back end together, so that should help. And then I'll have this pin over here to help hold the front end together once I get it on. Okay, so we're going to try to do this, guys. Let's see how it goes. I'm going to get these on, that on. And we're just going to put these into place and lift this up just a hair without knocking those off if I can do this. All right, can you guys see what I'm doing here? I actually figured out a way to get them all to roll, so I'm just going to, I got some of them still stuck in place, but I'm going to roll some of them, so we'll see what happens, so you can see the difference in each. So I'm going to do, put them all in place, and then I'm going to drop the cap on it. This is going to be a pain in the rumple still, Robert was correct. Robert Sugar gave me this kit, guys. He donated the kit to build here live, and that's why I literally am building live here, guys, with you guys. And Paul will tell you, you know, and anybody else can tell you, when I do live, I mean live, you guys get to see all the oopses, you guys get to see all the mess-ups, all the things that get forgotten have to be redone. Nobody can tell me that they build a kit the first time perfectly. I'm sorry, that's not true. You had something that you had to change, something you didn't like, or something came out wrong, or the instructions looked different than you thought they did. You know, just kind of like what I just did. Okay, so there it is. Okay, so now it's back in place, and I got rolling rollers, guys, some of them, okay? I kind of like did oddballs, every other one and stuff. Okay, so now we got the right rollers going in the right place here. Got that in. Now let's finish this one off now. Now that the glue's not quite set up, I can make some of these roll. Okay, so that's rolling. That's rolling. That's rolling. Just don't let the glue set up all the way. Okay, so those are all rolling. Here we go. Nothing's coming apart. Okay, so now I got them rolling too now, guys. Okay, so I changed it over. See, instantly changed it over to a rolling mechanism. All right, so I'm going to pull this off because it came loose. I'm going to put a little bit more glue on here because I didn't put much. So now that I know I'm done, I can really glue it into place. And then I put the end caps on the other things, and we did this, dudes. We did it. I did it. I figured it out. Like I said, the instructions aren't very clear on this thing, guys, and I apologize for you guys having to deal with me doing my oopses and watching them instead of just getting a nice clean build. But you and I both know that nobody builds perfectly the first time. Somebody changed something. Somebody didn't like it. The instructions had a number wrong, something. Instructions didn't have numbers on the sprue, something like that. So, I am just hanging out building, Tony. This is basically what I do, Tony. You're welcome to come. I do it every. I try to do it every day at 10 a.m. Try to do it right here at PAA. Sometimes if PAA is clogged up or giving me a problem, I may go ahead and shoot it to YouTube. If you want to check that out, Tony, it's the same name, Plastic Addictions Anonymous on YouTube. And all my videos go there eventually. So for those who missed them here, or for those who don't see them here, can see them other places. My family sometimes goes and views them and stuff like that. And that is open, by the way, YouTube. If you guys have something, Tony, if you want to make a small video, I'll put it out there of your auction or something. I'll put it out to brother. I don't mind. I don't care. It's fine by me. It's not like I've paid thousands of dollars to get the site up and running or something. It's just a Facebook thing. So if you want to, or a YouTube thing, if you want to go out there and do it and yell at me and send it to me, I'll be glad to chump it up out there. All right, so guys, now we're going to do 58 to 68 and 69. So 58 are going to be the pins, which are two of them, which I have one already in, and these are also 103s. Two 103s back to back with the bevel out. Pin goes in one side of the bevel. This is going to be number 69. I wrote it inside. This is going to be number 69. See, I didn't mess that up. All right, so now we got all this thing going, and this one is going to go. Look, I'm looking at the instructions. The bigger one goes to the... This one goes here, just like the other one did. It goes right here, just like this one. So if you put this one right next to it, you kind of match it up, guys, just so you know. So this one goes here on top like that one did. So we'll put a little bit of glue down here on the base to get it to stay put. Wait, I'm doing it wrong. That goes here. I'm wrong. Shut me up now, guys. See? Oops. All right, I'm glad I didn't glue it, guys. That's kind of embarrassing, you know? not really, because I kind of like showing you guys the oopsies.
Yeah, I was just saying, why is it embarrassing? It's normal.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. I kind of like showing you guys the oopsies. You know, you get more out of the video when you get to see the screw-ups, guys. Think about it. If somebody just hands you a built kit, you know, and shows you just the process of making everything just perfectly right, and then they show you the whole entire kit right, did you learn anything? Really? No. I mean, yes and no. But me? You guys get to see what the actual struggle is. You know, building
you
a model.
You guys get to see what not to do.
There you go. What not to do next? Exactly. Get to don't follow me. You know, don't do exactly what I do. But understand that these are the issues you can have. These are the issues I have. So I gotta paint the chrome here or the silver here as well, guys. I'll do that. I love you, brother. It's okay, baby. I got you. It's all right. I got you, Paul. I got you, buddy. Just remember, I got something I'm gonna be hanging on my flag this weekend. You guys gotta watch out for that. I'm gonna be shooting. Don't stop the oops, is I do, damn it. Okay, Steve. Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm saying, man. We all do oops. Trust me. Paul says he got it Saturday morning. Paul said he got everything and he loaded up and he took off. When I went out to straighten up the trailer, which he did a great job straightening up. Thank you, Paul. You didn't have to do all that, brother. I found a pair of shorts that he wore to the beach and a pair of skibbies. Okay, I'm Southern, guys. Skibbies are underwear. I shouldn't say skibbies. You guys probably won't get it. Some of you may. Skibbies is
first thing I asked, were they clean?
That's the first thing. I also made the comments of, was I wearing gloves or did I use a pair of, something to cover my skin? Oh, my goodness. We did another oops, guys. See, I'm talking and not paying attention. Right, a pair of tongs or did I use a rake or something, a shovel or something? But I told him I was going to, you know, if he couldn't guess what they were and figure out exactly what he left, I was going to hang him from my flagpole. So you guys got to check that out because I might still do it. Now that he's busted my chops, you better look out. I'll hang his underwear out there and put his name on it.
You ain't got a hair you know where if you don't now.
You're right there. You know what? You're right there. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do one better. I'm going to hang it from the TV antenna of the trailer out front.
There you go.
See if my wife notices. I'll do that tonight. I'll picture it. I'll do that tonight and see if my wife notices when she gets home.
Double dog dare
you. No. You can't go. No, okay. That's it. It's on, guys. Watch out for that. Watch out for No, there was no skid mark, Steven. I didn't look close enough anyways to find out if there was, but I grabbed him in his shorts too, by the way, not his underwear. I did not pick up his underwear. I picked up his shorts. I picked up the underwear with the shorts. Paul, they're talking about your skid marks now, brother.
Hey, Greg.
Yell in the front. You guys are freaking killing me, I swear to God. All right, so listen up, guys. I just got double.
I'm gonna have to go back and read the comments.
I just got double dog dared to put on a pair of underwear on my travel trailer's antenna. Guys, watch out! Pictures are on their way. I might even shoot a little 60-second video. But you know what? I gotta wait for it. I gotta wait for it to be a little windy and rainy, which it's probably not gonna be today. But I might go out there and just shoot some pictures of them just up there, just for the hell of it. Just for the hell of it. But then when it's rainy and or it's all windy and the wind's coming in, Paul's seen it. The wind comes in before the storms, it gets nice blowing. I'll get a good little video of them flapping in the wind for you too. First thing I'm gonna do is send them to his wife. You took your second, didn't it, Paul? Steven, don't worry, brother. He just double dog dared me, and nobody double dog dares me, and I don't do it. That's probably how most of my spinal column got messed up, is people double dog daring me. You won't do that. I double dog dare you, and pff, there goes something. So, anyways, you guys are driving me crazy. You know, you guys are going to make me bananas more than I already am. But I'm going to do it now. Now he's done did it. He done stepped in it now. And luckily I didn't have to step in it to pick up the pants. So
don't step in Zeus's.
Right. Oh my God, I felt so embarrassed, Paul, walking around outside in flip flops and my dog shits all over. My dog stuff's all over the yard. Okay, Facebook, I did not say that word. You're imagining it. So anyway, oh my God, I just got the picture of your pants hanging up on my thing. Oh my God, my wife's gonna kill me, but I'm gonna do it. She's gonna kill me. The neighbors are gonna think I'm out of my freaking mind.
But Tina, he double dog dared me.
That's what I'm gonna say. But honey, Paul double dog dared me. What was I supposed to do? Shit.
I had to man up.
Oh my God, this is gonna be so great. You guys gotta watch out for this. I swear to God, I'm doing it. In the next 48 hours, guys, look for the pictures. I'm gonna do it in the next 48 hours. You watch. And I'm gonna tag everybody. So, Paul, you got about 2,000 members from several groups and 100 TikTokers that are going to see that.
Hey, you're going to make me go viral.
I hope it does. Oh, my God. I didn't think about that. That's a good one, Paul. You're right. I didn't even think about that. We could. That might make it go viral. The stupidest shit stuff goes viral. Excuse me, guys. Oh my God! I gotta watch that where I'm at. I'm sorry. I know. I'm live. I'm not. It's not just me and you. I know I'm live. I know. Okay, guys. Stephen Mount says no video or pictures, no proof. Were you in the Navy? That's what they call underwear. No skivvies. No. My father was a Marine. He did a lot of paratrooping stuff and jumping out of planes in the waters with a lot of SEALs and stuff like that. He used to say that a lot to me. Go change your skibbies. Yeah. It's just one of those things, guys, that stuck with me through my life. That every time I say it, I do remember my father. Thank you, Stephen, very much. but no, I was not in the Navy, pal. Like I said, my father was in the military and, you know, did a lot of stuff with aquatics. And he was actually the first Broward County diver here to do rescue recovery in the 70s, which was an awesome thing to be around as a young child. I got so many adventures of watching him suit up and hit the water and bring people out of the water safely and bring cars out of the water. And, you know, it was just an awesome thing. I learned a lot. Hoorah, Semper Fi, Jeff says, Paul. Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you very much, Jeff. All good. So I see him here.
He wasn't a Marine either.
So, but and I haven't been in the military, but my father and my grandfather and a couple of my uncles that passed in a motorcycle. One of my uncles that passed in a motorcile accident had nothing to do with the military. Was in the military with them. He was a sniper and. I forget where they sent him. But I know my uncle spent like 2 weeks in a tree once, just sitting waiting for his mark. He used to tell that story all the time when we'd sit around at the dining room table and stuff. Go ahead, Paul.
82nd Airborne.
Paul was 82nd Airborne, right? I was trying to think if it was 87th or 82nd. Sorry, brother. I knew it was 82nd or 80 something, but I wasn't sure if it was 7 or 2. 82. 82nd Airborne he was in.
82nd Airborne Division.
So, You're a Marine, Jeff. Cool. Awesome, brother. Love it. Thanks for your service, brother. I really appreciate it. You guys are why we have our liberties today, man. There's no doubt. If it hadn't been for the past military and the present military, we could have been in really bad shape.
That's why you get to hang underwear from your antenna.
Exactly. Paul is exactly right. That's exactly right. That is why I have the right to hang my buddy's underwear from my travel trailer antenna where my entire neighborhood can see it without anybody saying anything. And like I said, I will probably do a video on TikTok and see how that goes. And I'm going to make the comment, I got double dog dared, and see what happens. That's a good one, Paul. That's a good one. Very good, Paul. Very good. So, okay, let me give a shout out to every platform that we're on, guys, so everybody can find us. We are on Facebook, of course. Here we have The Model Asylum and Plastic Addictions Anonymous. We are on YouTube. Plastic Addictions Anonymous is all you got to search. Look for my cement mixer in the banner area. Also, we are on, I'm losing it. Twitter is Plastic Addictions Anonymous, all one word, or Plastic Addictions, all one word. We are also on TikTok, Plastic Addictions, one word. We are also on, what's the other one? Instagram. Insta is Plastic_Addictions_Anonymous. We are on just about every platform I could think of, guys. Go check it out. Give me some likes and shares. Let's see if we can't make this plastic world blow up. That's my object, is to make, you know, everybody that doesn't see what we do and what we go through, what we see and what we go through on a daily basis, to love the plastic and to love the build. Everybody can see it that way. I guess that's why we also built Facebook, was that we wanted everybody to see, you know, not only could you guys see what we do and how we do it, but we get to see what you guys do and how well you do and how different you guys build. Like you guys saw in our little build off, we are so different, but we are so the same. Just point in case, my wife and all of us were sitting there talking about old time cartoons. Paul and I had never discussed that old cartoons. My wife said something about really old cartoons, and Paul pops in with Hong Kong Phooey. I almost fell, guys. That's my most, in the world, that's my most favorite cartoon in the world. I love Hong Kong Phooey. If somebody made a Hong Kong Phooey build that was as big as my house, I'd go try to build it. So I love Hong Kong Phooey, and Paul loved Hong Kong Phooey. Like I said, we're so the same and so the different, guys. He likes cartoons and stuff. He plays plastic. He's got a great humor. He's, you know, he takes things lightly. He doesn't get upset about things easily. So we're such oddballs. I guess they say opposites attract, though, brother. So
brothers from different mothers.
That's exactly what it is. Just brothers from different mothers with different genes on. Exactly. So, but I just wanted to say thank you, guys. You guys are why I do this. Come in here and do this. Have your third, damn it. Okay, Steven's doing my stuff. Steven, man, you're not supposed to follow what I do. You're supposed to learn from what I do and not do it, brother. Steven's got his third damn oops in a couple of minutes. He says, damn it. Oh, okay, yeah. He had his third damn it in a couple of minutes, which basically is my third oops. That way it could have been fourth or fifth oops, you know. He may be missing a couple of them there, just so you know. Well, see, that's what I'm saying. You know, you guys get to see, you get to see the differences in how everybody builds. We all have fun. I talk, you know, I'm trying to keep, you know, everybody as active as possible. Again, I want to give a shout out to the Model Asylum. I will be doing the breakfast this week. It'll start back up. Paul was here for a week, so I kind of took a break on things, and I fell behind, so I had to go out and check everything and make sure everybody's good. We are growing, by the way. We are 2% above our normal, which is an amazing thing, which means we got more members, more postings, more commenting. Everybody, you know, went in and did what they were supposed to do, which was make sure the group gets, you know, a little love. You know, if you guys come in for 2 seconds and give us a little love, it literally does show, and the algorithms and Facebook will actually put our name out there. But I'm sure the more you say it, the more you do it, the more people will get the name out. The only thing that I do request is on the Facebook ones only, which Paul and I are going to discuss. I had an idea. Maybe we could change that up a little bit. But you must be a builder or collector to be on those two groups only. Anywhere else on any one of my other platforms, you do not have to be a builder or collector. You can be someone who's standing in a model store saying, hey, I might want to buy this model. Do you think it's a good model for me? That would be fine by me. You know, and that's why I created it. You get it, guys? Number three group I'm giving a shout out to that I have started, that Paul, I think, is in, 17 others so far, is Fantastic Plastic Model Garage. Look out for it out there on Facebook, guys. Go check it out. That's for your novices, guys.
You started another one?
Yeah, that's for guys who are not, and guys, girls, kids, anybody. and it is open to the public. Anybody can join. It's for people that want to learn to build, that have never built before or are thinking about building and just want to check it out. I don't want to change the rules for these two because I want you guys safe and not have to deal with all the bull crap, outside influences, somebody tagging somebody else or somebody saying, hey, you know, you did this, that, or the other. You guys come in, you post your builds, you have some fun, you talk models, and you go on your way. That's all good. You know, no drama in these groups whatsoever. And I know bringing a group live and open to the public causes that sometimes. Oh, you're working on the front and rear ends of the truck you're working on. Oh, I get you. So just so you know, it is an open group, and I am letting just about anybody on. I don't want to change the group rules here. I thought about it, and I like keeping you guys to where you guys can just. The hardest thing for me to do is open up the link thing, guys. I'm just concerned that, you know, we open up link things, people stop popping links in, and we start going to other people's groups that aren't secure and aren't safe, and now we get people in and coming in, and I'm spending, you know, 4 hours trying to tell people, no, you don't build, you don't collect, you can't come in. You know what I mean? I'd rather just, you know my rules. If you invite somebody, you know our rules. If you invite somebody, make sure they know it. Or you're a collector.
Maybe just leave those two alone.
Yeah, I think those two are just going to stay the way they are. You need to be a collector or builder on those two groups, and we're not going to really do anything with those. I appreciate, and I've gotten a few comments as to asking me why no links, why no outside influences. But that's it in nutshells. I just don't want to have to deal with going in and every time.
It gets cluttered.
It looks nasty. You know, I mean, you can scroll through our group and see nothing but models, guys. Maybe a mem now and then that I let slip by because I saw it and I thought it was funny, or a meme, whatever you got, however you guys call it. But otherwise, you know, if you post a link out without talking to one of us first.
It's a meme in South Florida. Everybody else, he's talking about memes.
There's that Southern charm of mine again. I'm sorry,
hey,
Steve.
The underwear thing's done deal, so I can say what I want now.
Yeah, right? That's it. He's good now. He's getting it. He's going to get it in the end. So definitely, guys, watch out for that. I will be posting that. I will post that to Facebook and the Model Asylum just so everybody gets to see it. Yes, I am going to post pictures that have nothing to do with models. Yes, I'm going to post another man's underwear hanging from a antenna, and yes, I'm gonna crack the hell up about it while I'm doing it. So, and I might die when my wife gets home, so y'all just you know y'all can fight over my kids, okay? I don't know. Paul knows everything I have. He's been here, so y'all can do it with him. My wife may take him out and burn him after this, just so you know, and call Paul and burn him too fast. But I'm gonna do it. She'll get a
kiss. I got another 17-hour drive to go pick up model kits.
All I want to say on my grave was he tried the plastic thing. That's all I want on my gravestone, guys. He was a plastic fanatic. Something to do with plastic. And at my funeral, you guys, you know, can come in with Nerf guns and try to fight over my models if you want. Since whoever's still standing wins. Our next show will be number 14. We are done with number 13 and number 12, guys. Oh, my God. When I come back, I will have the rest of this one painted around the trim, and I will have this one all finished back up and second coated. I think that's about it, guys. Other than Paul, I can't believe you the whole show, brother. Driving down the road, man. You must be a long ways away from work.
Well, I did go in and get my parts.
I heard you get out.
I got a cup of coffee, but.
Oh, by the
way. I just left you running while I went in the store.
Yeah, I heard that. I do appreciate each and every one of you. He'll use a taser. Well, I don't think my wife would let you use a taser at my funeral. She might. Yes, exactly, Stephen. I appreciate you saying that. And that's exactly one of the reasons. Stephen says this is one of the few groups where I don't see scammers posting. So exactly. And you know,
we really try to monitor what's going on.
We do. And Samuel Stokes does our night stuff, so he does pretty good. He pretty much keeps it nice and clean with us too. And if he does have any problem, he does contact me and let me know what happened when he does it. And then I go check out the post and stuff and see if that's it. And, you know, we have never, Paul, me, nor Sam, I don't think on anything we've removed have ever disagreed on it. We've all agreed that doesn't belong here, or he doesn't belong here. In the past, since I've started this YouTube thing, in the past, I don't know, month, let's say, I've probably denied 36 people, 37 people, maybe 40 people. Just because they came in, they didn't answer the questions, they didn't read the rules and agree to the rules, or I went to their Facebook page, their profile, they didn't have any pictures of models, they didn't have any groups that I could go see that I could say that were in common. You know, I belong to 300 groups. I'm sure each and every one of my members out of 2,000 members belong to at least two of the same groups I do. Okay, so I just want to say, you don't belong to any model group. You don't have any model pictures. Why do you want to come into a model club? I mean, that's like taking, you know, a dog to a, you know, car show and saying, hey, here's my car. It doesn't work that way. You know what I mean? So we do deny some, I admit it, and we'd probably be at 3,000 by now if we hadn't denied them. But guess what? I don't want, like you said, exactly, I don't want the scammers in. I don't want the guys that want to come in and just say, hey, you know, sell this, sell that. Don't get me wrong, I love everybody, but I don't want it clean, guys. I want to, you know, some now and then I like memes go by because I thought they were funny. Out links, most links, if you haven't talked to us about it, I will remove if there's an outside link, unless you discuss it with me or Paul or Sam first. Or one of the other admin, you can discuss it with them because they'll discuss it with me before they make the decision, or Paul. But we do have three admin. If there's any problem, guys, there's plenty of people to get a hold of. Even when it, you know, at Eastern time when I'm asleep, my buddy Sam works nights, so he's up really, really late watching the groups for us. And I appreciate that. That's a shout out to Mr. Sam. But I want to give a shout out to my admins, which are Paul Lovelace, Samuel Stokes, myself, Joe Fritz is one of my moderators. Chris Bryan is one of my moderators. Oh, speaking of Chris Bryan, I'd like you guys to go to Danger Close Dioramics and check him out, dangerclosedioramics.com. He has some great resins in there. Give him a yell. Tell him I sent you. Go check him out if you guys want to buy some.
Don't tell him. He'll charge you double.
He might, just for knowing me and just for mentioning my name, he might charge you double. So that's about it, guys, for the show. I appreciate everybody. Man, Tony, man, I'm so happy that you came, man. You're a first-timer, and I want to give you a shout-out for sure. Again, Tony Leonard, Kenny Gilmore, they run it's all junk plastic auctions. Please, guys. It's all junk. Sorry, I put the plastic auction in there. It's a model auction. I'm a plastic head. Plastic comes out of my mouth 100 million times a day.
If you've ever watched one of their auctions, it's great.
Yeah, if you've had
absolutely hilarious.
It's great. And
Candy and Tony do a great job with their auctions.
They sure do, and they sure do. We, you know, I've been to a bunch of them, and I kind of hid in the background because I didn't want to order. I couldn't afford it. If you can afford something, man, don't order. Go out there and check it out. You know, you don't have to pay for something if you don't have the money for it. That's the biggest thing. You know, you should know.
Don't bid if you ain't got the money.
Right. Don't bid if you ain't got the money. And then there's nobody chasing you down. That's the biggest thing. You know. Oh, I know they don't run it. Hi, Joseph. Oh my God. Hey, Joseph, how you doing? Joseph Schaefer just popped in. How you doing, buddy? They don't run it, no? Well, they do auctions on it. How about that? They do auctions on it as well. Well, thanks for dropping in, Joseph. I appreciate you, man. Thanks very much. You're popping in at the end. We got about 5 minutes left, and I'm going to be popping out. But we're working on the AMT D8H bulldozer that I got from Samuel Shugru. Did you hear what I just said? Robert Shugru. My goodness.
Cheap, dude.
Yeah, I know. Oops, exactly. There you go, guys. Look, everything is live. I don't edit that crap out. Robert, I apologize for that, brother. Your name is not Sam. I may call you Sam a couple of times, but it's not Sam. When I come back, we will do number 14, guys, which is putting the tracks in, putting the tracks together, and a few basic track attachment parts, as you can see.
Hey, Joe?
Yes, sir. Oh, I didn't turn that on. Yes, sir.
I am pulling back in, dude. I'm going to hop off here.
All right, brother.
Thanks for joining us this morning, guys.
Appreciate you, brother Paul. Be safe up there, brother.
Yeah, man.
All right, bye. Brother. Out. All right, guys. That was Paul from Ohio, the co-founder here. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. You've been here? I didn't realize, Joseph. I'm sorry. I've been doing building and talking and not looking at the Facebook thing. And I do have it up, believe it or not. I'll give everybody a shout out when I go and I'm done with the video, when I go back and check it out before I put it out. I usually try to add a shout out to everybody and thank them. but I do appreciate everybody. You guys, like I said, I do live videos, and I mean live. Like I said, I appreciate what the guys do out there when they show the builds and they do their builds and they're getting money because they're putting, you know, names and ads and all those things on their stuff. And, you know, they're putting big logos in the front and nice little starting skits and stuff like that. But my videos are me building. If I would, you know, just start say, oops, wait a minute, after you guys saw the whole video and I cut out those oops, you guys would know I was cutting them out. Would you like that I cut them out? No, you want to see what it's going to take to build that model, right? Maybe you'll run into that same problem. Maybe you won't. You know, like I did today. I realized that I had the 199 on the wrong one. I had two of them, not one. So I had to pull it apart and refix it. But now, I am a happy hamper. See, we are happy plasticers. So anyways, guys, Love and peace to everybody. Shout out to everybody that came. I really appreciate it, guys. You guys are my heart. I do this for you guys, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. It's some fun talk. It's some fun stuff. Pay attention, guys. Plastic Addiction Anonymous and the Model Asylum. Watch out for some flying skibbies. Love you guys. I'm out of here. I'll see you guys in the morning. Maybe I'll pop in later on tonight if I feel a little frisky. I'm doing some more plastic. Everybody have a good day. Like, subscribe, share, follow for you guys on YouTube. Hit that bell so you get notifications. And I will see everybody in the morning. Peace out, guys. Plastic on.